Hi, you're watching Stylemint, and joining me today is one of India's most accomplished and most gifted designers, a young achiever, Nachiket Barve. Nachiket, welcome to Stylemint.
Thank you for those kind words.
Do tell us about the color palette that we're going to see in the coming season.
For the coming festive season and the the winter collections, you'll see a lot of black. You'll see navy, you'll see eggplant, you'll see teal, you'll see red. But you'll also see the neon pinks, and because that's something which is fabulous on Indian skin. So it's something which will carry forth from the summer trends, but it'll be in a more subdued jewel tones rather than being pop in your face. In terms of silhouettes, I see, like a certain sense of either super structured or with extreme ease. So where with the whole sort of sense of the 30s being back in vogue with the Great Gatsby, in fact, my Automata collection is called the Art Deco. And it's inspired by the Art Deco movement and a sense of, the color blocking and the ease of silhouettes, a flapper style way of wearing clothes. So those details, those elements of the clothing and the fashion of the 30s have been reinterpreted in a contemporary format.
And how big is Art Deco going to be, and what is the easiest way of incorporating that in your wardrobe?
See, any trend or any sort of design movement that one is inspired by, it's about taking the essence of it and reinterpreting it for modern times. So while you might be inspired by the 30s and the 40s, you don't want to wear it as is. You want to sort of either have a yoke on a dress, or you could even do accessories inspired by Art Deco. It's about adding, if you're bold, go all out and use it. If you are sort of somebody who is more conservative in a style, you can do a little element of it. So it's really how you choose to wear it.
In terms of accessories for Art Deco, what would you recommend?
Maybe you just want to wear a cocktail dress and have an Art Deco, a huge choker inspired by the movement. Or you want to wear a sotwa inspired with a bias cut dress. So I feel fashion is an important part, but rather than following trend, it's important to create your own style. You look at icons Audrey Hepburn or Grace Kelly, or you look at, Rajmata Gayatri Devi, or even a Lady Gaga.
Yeah.
They're memorable because they have a signature style.
Absolutely.
And I think that is what every individual has to aspire to achieve, because then that's where fashion becomes self-expression rather than merely being, following the path.
Will the coming season also see a lot of surface texturing and some amount of bling, considering it's festive?
We are the land of India, and we've got a long history of both embellishment, surface ornamentation, as well as what the West has termed as blings. So be it bling or be it surface ornamentation, it can be done very elegantly, chicly in a modern format, or it can look tacky. So I think, surface ornamentation and bling will definitely be in, but it'll be in a more subdued, chic, graceful format. Maybe rather than going out for a full gold, you'll go for a burnished gold or an oxidized gold. You'll do a tarnished copper. You will do a gunmetal, a pewter. So those are the colors which I feel will be in vogue rather than in-your-face bright things. And even embellishments have become more tonal, more subtle, or then very, very statement. So somewhere it's also about being able to use those trends and make them adaptable to your own wardrobe and style. And that's what I think fashion this season will see.
Also, what do you think are the key pieces that should find place in the global Indian woman's wardrobe?
A well-fitted pair of blue jeans, because you can't go wrong with that. It's important to have a nice dress. It can be a black dress, a colored dress, but an evening dress cocktail, which is a no-brainer. It has to be like a best friend, which you can just snap and sort of use at a blink of an eye. A modern way to wear a cocktail sari also, I think, will see a resurgence, because you're seeing younger girls wear it. You're seeing, and for us also, you have somebody who's 18 wear a sari and somebody who's 60 wear the sari. And they wear it differently. And that for me is a very exciting way to wear it. What also is an important key element, I think, is what the Indians we call as a tunic or a kurti, because you can either wear it as a dress, or you can wear it over tights, or you can wear it your own way. But it lends itself to being worn democratically.
Right.
And that's something which I think is immensely flattering on Indian women.
Right.
And we don't need to follow Western format of, a blouse with pants, because the pear-shaped body doesn't permit that.
Yeah.
But the tunic worn with leggings is, I think, a great way to sort of Indianize, yet keep it within a contemporary realm.
The coming season, since it's festive, would also see a lot of sari. But for the young woman, how do you, how do you kind of advise them to contemporarize it? Is the dual pattern sari one way of doing it, or, just the drape? How does one contemporize the sari?
And you're taking on something which is, sort of 6 yards of uncut fabric. And trying to sort of give it a modern spin. And women today want to wear saris, want to experiment. It can be quirky, it can be playful, it can be light, but it has to fit it into their lifestyles. They don't want to be weighed down with a 30 kilo sari, unless it's a wedding.
And finally, one trend that Nachiket Barve would like to see go away and never return.
One, I think there's quite a...
You can have more than one then.
Well, I think there was something known as the padded shoulder a few seasons ago, which made all women look like quarterbacks, which was horrible. It's a nice trend on the catwalk, but the crop top with pants, for example, I mean, you know, Indian women, or most women have a belly. And I think fashion, the way I see it, has to be a part of your life and not the be-all and end-all of your life.
Yeah.
So, fashion should give you joy, not make you cry in the trial room. So,
thank you so much, Nachiket, for your time. Thank you.